gloves are off in the battle for Delhi, and it is a direct showdown between Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP. It started with the AAP chief training his guns on Delhi BJP president, alleging a nexus between Satish Upadhyay and power discoms. Arvind Kejriwal accused the Delhi BJP president of owning five companies that are allegedly working with power distribution companies. He demanded that the BJP come clean on the conflict of interest and its leaders' ties with power suppliers in Delhi.
श्री सतीश उपाध्याय जी की पांच और कंपनियां हैं। इन बाकी कंपनियों के भी बिजली कंपनियों के साथ क्या संबंध हैं? वो सतीश उपाध्याय जी क्लियर करें। और चुनाव के बाद, जब आम आदमी पार्टी की सरकार बनेगी, और हम बिजली कंपनियों का ऑडिट दोबारा करवाएंगे, तब जब सतीश उपाध्याय जी नेता विपक्ष होंगे, तो क्या वो उसमें टांग अड़ाएंगे या आम आदमी पार्टी की सरकार को शांति से इन कंपनियों का ऑडिट करने देंगे?
Soon, Satish Upadhyay hit back, challenging Kejriwal to prove his allegations and filing a defamation case against the Aam Aadmi Party chief.
निश्चित रूप से क्रिमिनल डेफेमेशन कल ही डालेंगे. पहले भी वो इन सब चीजों में आ चुके हैं. हिट एंड रन की पॉलिसी उनकी है. और अगर ये दोनों कंपनियां नहीं मिली और ऐसा नहीं हुआ, तो फिर वो निकल कर ऐसे ही भाग जाएंगे या राजनीति छोड़ देंगे?
उन्होंने तो सारी बातें मान ली. हमने कहा था इन्होंने बिजली के मीटर लगाए थे और रिप्लेस किए थे. वो मीटर सतीश उपाध्याय जी की कंपनी ने लगाए थे और समय समय पे जब खराब हुए तो रिप्लेस किए थे. सबूत सारे उनको बोले, वेबसाइट पे सबूत है. अब उनको अपनी अपनी इज्जत बचाने के लिए ये दिखाएंगे डिफेमेशन कर रहे हैं.
The battle for Delhi is heating up, and it's a direct fight between the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP. Accusations and counter-accusations are flying thick and fast. While the Aam Aadmi Party has decided to make the alleged BJP power company's nexus a poll plank, the BJP, as usual, has dismissed it as unsubstantiated claims. The gloves are off, but both the parties realize beyond facts and figures, the game now is to win the public perception. In New Delhi with camera person DK Sharma, Ankit Tyagi for Headlines Today.
The big question, open war now between the BJP and the Aam Aadmi Party. The big question is corruption, the single biggest issue between the Delhi voter or indeed any voter now in an election. Corruption the biggest issue? Let's raise that with our panelists. Joining me now on our panel tonight, Rahul Mehra, spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party. Nalin Kohli, national spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Amrita Dhawan, Congress spokesperson, will join me shortly. Dr. Manisha Priyam, senior political analyst who's tracking the Delhi elections for us, is also joining us. Appreciate your joining us. I want a straight answer from you, Nalin Kohli. The allegations being made essentially is that your BJP president Satish Upadhyay is a majority shareholder in at least six companies, including two which were directly supplying meters to the Delhi government through the BSES. Which provides power to Delhi. As a result, A, there's a conflict of interest, and B, there are serious questions being raised whether these meters that were supplied were faulty, because there have been allegations that this is leading to very high power tariffs. How do you explain this conflict of interest which the Aam Aadmi Party claims that your BJP president has?
I mean, let's go first at the political point. We can't go by a conflict of interest status coming from Mr. Kejriwal. Mm-hmm. Mr. Kejriwal is a constitution unto himself. Mm-hmm. He can determine to look at everything as it suits him and change his stance on that too. Now, I don't want to go into a whole series
no,
of...
No, I want a straight answer.
I'm coming.
Does your party president own six companies which install and replace fast-running electricity meters, all of them working with the power discoms?
Well, let's go one by one. Mr. Upadhyay has said he'll quit politics.
Yes.
If you can prove any misgiving or misdoing or any thing which is incorrect.
That could be
legally.
Bravado.
No, one minute, hold on. Why bravado? You hold him responsible. He's on the television channels. Mm-hmm. Mr. Kejriwal, for everything he has said, mm-hmm. he says all the things on the website. We heard about 400 pages against Sheila Dikshit. Mm-hmm. She and her ministers will be in jail in 15 days. Mm-hmm. Neither did we see anyone go to jail. And what happened to the material on the website? Mm-hmm. It disappeared. Or about the Vadra case, the person who facilitated land issues being sorted out, they gave him a ticket in Haryana. So let's not go only by the allegations. Let's talk by substance. Two companies are not even known of. Then they say those details are not there. They have siphoned off. Mr. Upadhyay, if I have correctly heard, has said he is not supplied to BSES. The statement of the Aam Aadmi Party is called...
He has said he has supplied, but this happened before 2012. Let's be clear. Satish Upadhyay has admitted that there were companies, but they were supplying before 2012. They don't supply it today.
Thank you. So it's a point. You have corrected it. Thank you. Because as I said, I haven't heard his statement. Now let's go to the last point.
Yes.
In the press release, they are saying Mr. Ashish Sood is vice president. He's the general secretary. They've not done their homework. They made an allegation. They need to say something to create some kind of credibility, given the fact that they have no issues to stand on. The last of it, and this is my last point. Today evening, Mr. Kejriwal apparently has said that I left government because the Congress was harassing me. We never heard this before. At that time, it was supposed to be the Jan Lokpal, which nobody would have opposed. Today, it's the Congress was supporting, was troubling us. So he's known to make allegations. That's his model. Good luck to him.
Can I just take that for a moment to Rahul Mehra? Rahul Mehra, in what Nalin Kohli is saying is perhaps what many suggest about Arvind Kejriwal. Hit and run politics, where your credibility is on test because you've made allegations in the past against Sheila Dixit. As Nalin says, you promised to put her in jail. You did nothing of the sort. You've also made allegations against other BJP leaders in the past, but they have not been proven in any court of law. So the question will arise, is this Arvind Kejriwal back to hit and run politics?
Rajdeep, it all depends on how you want to actually conduct this program over the next half hour. Are we going to get into a tutu meme with BJP? So they accuse us, we accuse them, and we stop talking on substance.
I want to know, is your leader going to be reduced to a rhetorical charge? Your leader has raised a very specific charge.
Rajdeep, allow me.
The BJP is responding by claiming it's a lie. So you need to prove your charge.
Rajdeep, I've understood. Rajdeep, please allow me to make my point. I've understood your question.
Yes.
Just hear me out, please. So all I'm saying is I can go back and say that, you know, the Prime Minister, when he was campaigning, he was talking about Jamai Raja. What happened to Jamai Raja? Where is the FIR? Why is it that they can't even stop him at the airport? Why such VVIP culture is existing? Why is it that nothing has happened over the 50 crore girlfriend that he commented about? In fact, her husband was amongst the Navratnas of Swachh Bharat campaign. So we can go on and on. This will actually lead nowhere. He will accuse us, we will accuse him. So this is the politics that BJP and Congress have prevailed over the last 70 years in our country. Let's step back.
It's your leader who's made the accusation.
Let's talk about.
It's your leader who's made the accusation. I haven't made the accusation.
Sure. So I'm wanting to raise three questions. I have these documents, Rajdeep. I have these documents right in front of me.
Yes.
Which say two things. Substantively, you remember that when we came into power, we talked about 50% reduction. We reduced. BJP in their manifesto talked about 30% reduction. Prime Minister, through his rally, said 300 rupees per annum. Where is the 30% reduction? Now, you add up the all the things together. Till Mr. Dr. Harshvardhan was there, there was 30% reduction in the manifesto. Comes Satish Upadhyay with the change in the government at the center, that 30% is reduced to 300 rupees per annum through LED lights. Now, all we are saying is either The questions that we have raised and the figures and the documents that we are showing, ROC documents, are fudged. And you tell us that these are fudged. You tell us that the NCNL Infomedia Limited was not a company in which majority stake was of Satish Upadhyay. You tell us that, you know, he does not have a conflict of interest when the BJP comes into power, they will actually go ahead and follow the line and the path of audit of these companies, include especially the BSES. You tell us whether these meters had been obtained by you, by Satish Upadhyay's company or not. If yes, from where? How many meters were obtained? How many were installed?
Yes.
What price were they obtained at? What price were they passed on to the BSES and eventually to the customer? Whether these are running fast or not? Whether the fast meters through which the people feel the heat and the people are actually distressed are the ones which are being supplied by BJP or not?
You're asking for a response on facts, not rhetoric, because Satish Upadhyay and Nalin Kohli has responded
only
with
response.
Rhetoric. Satish Upadhyay has responded with rhetoric. Prove these charges or quit politics. Or if you don't prove these charges, I will take you to a court of law.
Yeah, well, of course, you know, Mr. Upadhyay. Well, hold on, let's go one by one.
Yes.
Mr. Upadhyay has started. clearly by saying that I'm going to file a criminal defamation. He's going to the court of law. Now here is a party that has built its entire political base filing PILs. They have some very substantive people in their at least original supporters. I don't see them so involved in the party now. So what happened? If they found it was so bad, they would have... Let me also go to another thing. All Mr. Mehra is trying to do, he's an advocate also, as am I. We meet in the Supreme, we see each other in the Supreme Court. Why have they... They are trying to conduct a trial in a television studio. I find it amusing.
You're saying nowhere, go to a court of law.
Nowhere. I'm saying it
You're
officially.
You're asking them to go for a court of law.
If they wish to. No, who's stopping
Rajdeep.
Them? This is the... 1 minute, let me finish, Mr. Mehra. You'll have ample opportunity.
Yes.
Sure. So therefore, let me put something clearly. Nowhere has it been claimed, and I'm putting it on the record, that they supplied meters, they only installed them, and that too before 2012. There's a massive difference in law in the meaning of installed and in a meeting of supply. Now, if you are trying to
He was getting effectively monetary benefit from the power discoms. How will a BJP president who is getting monetary benefit from a power discom then audit those very power discoms?
That's the question. No, no, I'll answer that also. Where, now the language has changed. The minute I point out that it is not a supply but an installation, and when was Mr. Satish Upadhyay made the president of the party? In 2012, before that, where was he the president of the party? Basically, what the Aam Aadmi Party would like to do is put everything under question, say that if a person has any dealing with anyone, so if I invite Mr. Rajdeep Sardesai for a cup of tea, does that mean that I'm trying to bribe him so that he gives me good coverage? This kind of logic only applies where 2 plus 2 will be 4 and become 40 because it's the Aam Aadmi Party's approach.
Can I just for a moment go to Manisha Priyam? Manisha Priyam, Rahul Mehra, I'll let you respond, but Manisha Priyam, is there a sense that we are now returning to the politics of December 2013? You might recall that before the December 2013 elections also, corruption featured prominently in the campaign. It was in the backdrop of allegations in the Commonwealth Games made against Sheila Dixit. Do you believe that in 2015 a similar campaign will work, or has the politics of Delhi and indeed the country changed after the general elections of last year? That you cannot practice the same kind of politics of making these allegations based on documents, yes, but based on documents which can be challenged.
Corruption is certainly a very important issue, and it's not just India. If you see, even in the Sri Lanka elections, corruption has been a very important issue, and a very confirmed Mr. Rajapaksa has been so shown the door really by a coalition that he never thought would even be able to rise up to him. So in that sense, corruption does remain a very important issue. But what I would like to point out here is that the Aam Aadmi Party right now is trying to poise the whole charge of corruption against the BJP. It may not be so successful. As Mr. Nalin Mehra has pointed out, Mr. Satish Upadhyay was not an incumbent in the government. And therefore, where is the conflict of interest? Anybody could be making power discoms. Suppose we are consuming coal, and then, you know, my party is likely to win the election, doesn't mean that I have a conflict of interest because the Colgate scam is being, you know, making power meters or even distributing it or installing it is not a wrongful business activity. I don't even know whether Mr. Upadhyay does any of these or not, but on the face of it, I can't see a conflict of interest.
Is it
between
being linked to the question
of
power?
Party, is it being also linked? Being a businessman?
Manisha Priyam, is it being linked to the question that in a city like Delhi or indeed in any city of the country, getting cheap, affordable and regular power is a big issue? So therefore, you try and link a political leader to power discom, suggest he's practicing crony capitalism and benefiting a few at the cost of many. Is that what is really the issue? Not just corruption per se, but how do you provide cheap power?
Okay, now by the long rope, therefore, this would be a worry for the Indian citizen whether he or she is getting these type of utilities that have been unbundled between 2005 onwards and that have led to the massive money inflow to the public exchequers and therefore the draining away of wealth as we saw in Delhi itself. If you remember, the Delhi government got all its money at hand freed up because of the privatization of power. But that is, as you can see, a long rope question whether the needle of that can be pointed sharply on to one Mr. Satish Upadhyay who takes on the mantle of a party called the BJP, which has not even been in power. I mean, that I think is a very long rope to the electorate, which is going to ask sharp questions, the issues of corruption will still remain stuck somewhat with the erstwhile Congress government that they see as having been associated with activities around the generation or privatization of power, not the BJP as much. So therefore, the Aam Aadmi Party here is played by the long rope and doesn't really seem to be a sharp electoral question as they had been able to pose in the last assembly election towards the outgoing Congress government.
Can I get Rahul Mehra to respond to that?
By a yardstick of imagination, certainly a public... Yeah.
Can I get Rahul? Yeah. Rahul, respond to that. Remember what happened in December 2013. You raised questions about alleged irregularities in the Commonwealth Games contracts. Sheila Dixit was in power then. She was became an identifiable symbol for you of what you called Congress corruption. You didn't prove it, but you raised it and effectively raised it. Now you are trying to raise it with the BJP leadership of the state level, not against Narendra Modi. These charges are not being made against Mr. Modi, who's the face of the BJP's campaign. You're making it against the state BJP president. And Manisha Priyam says that you will have to prove conflict of interest in the truest sense. People now will not go by allegations alone. They will want those allegations to be substantive enough for them to be convinced that the BJP president is indeed guilty of corruption.
So, Rajdeep, to start off, first of all, let me remind your viewers that there were five FIRs which were registered within a span of 49 days.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them very clearly was against the Chief Minister of Delhi.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what figment of imagination the opposition has right now,
mm-hmm.
and how conveniently they are just brushing aside that.
Mm-hmm.
Take it in contrast with the more than 7 months of center regime at the BJP that has been ruling India. Where is Haryana and other states, Rajasthan, where is the Jawai Raja, I'm asking? This was raised to the pitch where electoral benefits reaped. Where is the black money which was supposed to come? So, you know, very conveniently you just switch over sides and you flip the coin over thinking that people are fool, electorates don't understand and they have short memories. You know, people who live in glass houses should not throw thrown at others. Number two,
mm-hmm.
All I'm saying is, as far as the allegations out here are concerned, who has said that there's an act of corruption? Have we ever said that there is an act of corruption? All we are saying is, mm-hmm. we are putting certain facts which have come to us, and these are backed by documents, none other than the government agencies. And these are government agencies' documents.
You're not accusing them of corruption, but you're accusing them of cronyism. You're suggesting that the BJP state president in Delhi is someone who has monetarily benefited from power discoms, so he doesn't have the moral authority to audit power companies. Am I correct?
Let Mr. Satish Upadhyay put documents. Let Mr. Satish Upadhyay, paste those documents on our mouth and let him say that I haven't earned a single revenue and I haven't supplied these, I haven't procured or I haven't maintained, I haven't installed any of these meters. And all that the Aam Aadmi Party is saying is blatant lie. And that's where the matter is.
Can I get Nalin Kohli to respond? Nalin Kohli, respond to that. Can Satish Upadhyay put out documents in the public domain to deny the basic charge that he has monetarily benefited from power discoms? That's the charge which is being made.
But okay, let me just answer this. It's my last thing because I need to move
on. And reduction of 30% power.
Let me answer, Mr. Mehra, one minute. I'll finish all my points in one go. One by one. First of all, it starts that Mr. Satish Upadhyay enjoys a sterling reputation. That's why the Aam Aadmi Party is hesitant to even put a corruption charge on him. So they are saying conflict of interest. Mr. Upadhyay has answered that by saying I'll file a criminal defamation. And when you are talking of facts, Mr. Mehra is a lawyer too, as I pointed out.
Mm-hmm.
In the very point that they are putting out, they don't even know that Ashish Sood is the general secretary. They have not got their facts right.
No, I'm coming back to the central issue.
Let's go back. No one will finish.
That.
I remember
don't
all.
Go into.
Let me finish it, please. Mm. Now let's go to the third point. Mr. Modi has spoken about power in Delhi, so they don't have the guts to say he's talking about mobility, other things. The fourth thing is, as Manisha Priyamji has just pointed out, everything happens in the Congress ring, but the corruption is of the BJP. The fifth is, they said, in terms of allegation, where is the Jamai Raja? What happened to the man who protected the Jamai Raja? They conveniently gave him a ticket, Mr. Yudhvi, to contest during the Lok Sabha.
Oh, come on. Absolutely incorrect.
These are all allegations.
No, hold on. Nalin Kohli, let me ask you one thing. Do you believe that corruption is a central issue this time for the BJP, or do you believe the issues have moved after your victory in the May elections to good governance? That this election is not about a negative vote anymore. 2015 India is not a negative vote as to, because political parties no longer can take the moral high ground, most believe on corruption. Do you believe the terms of the debate have shifted, Nalin Kohli, in 2015?
Well, I mean, what is there that with Mr. Modi coming in, the fact is that the focus is on development. It's a politics of commitment. It's not a politics of allegations. And as far as the Aam Aadmi Party is there, by their logic, they should be declared CIA agents. Because after all, they had members of theirs who took heavy funding from the Ford Foundation. And people used to say that they are CIA agents.
You need to get even now, Rajdeep.
So therefore, these allegations, what Mr. Mehra started off at the beginning, it actually holds back true. They have a bunch of allegations. If they have the proof, go to court. And Mr. Upadhyay, in any case, is going to court.
Rajdeep.
I need to sign off. I need to move
on. You need to sign off. Just hold on for a minute.
No, Rajdeep, you must allow me.
Rajdeep, first of all, the moral high ground that you had in 2013, do you still have it in 2015 when it comes to corruption?
They don't have ground.
Absolutely. And I will give you examples of it. The only political party which is raising funds through white money, which is not unaccounted for, is the Aam Aadmi Party. To the last penny, every fund is there. And this Delhi High Court has reprimanded both BJP and Congress that they are hiding funds. As far as the allegation of CIA agent and all, that is all rubbish. Because that has been also rubbish, and that has we have been vindicated by the High Court. The central government, both of the BJP and the Congress, has gone threadbare into our accounts and could not get even an iota of evidence of any illegal foreign funding or illegal Indian funding. Number two, as far as the question of Mr. Modi is concerned, it's all, you know, today Mr. Modi's government has been reduced to maximum ordinance, minimum governance is what Mr. Modi stands for today. I don't know what Mr. Kohli is talking about.
Can I just come to Manisha Priyam? I don't want to now make it between, you know, just the Congress and I just want a final word from you, Manisha Priyam, and where I started off. The big difference in 12 months, at the time, if you remember, Sheila Dixit became, in a sense, the focus of the Aam Aadmi Party's anger, in a sense. They crystallized public anger on corruption. 12 months later, do you still believe the same anger exists? Or do you believe things have changed? That cities like Delhi or indeed the country has moved to other issues. This whole notion of good governance has taken over from a negative anti-corruption plank when it comes to the voter.
Rajdeep, as I said in our bigger debate day before, corruption does remain a very important issue. And the Aam Aadmi Party is indeed trusted by the underclass of Delhi as a party that is non-corrupt. But if you see, the explanation to this question lies in your numbers that you had on the seat projections. Clearly, we will see the Aam Aadmi Party trying to say that we can handle corruption better than them. Now, where do they make the charge? They can't make it against a Congress party which is likely to do worse than it had. So you will see this kind of slugfest in your studios in the days to come. Here are both parties that think that they can make it to the portals of Delhi Assembly, and both of them are equally poised. You know, remember, the BJP has not been the incumbent ruling party in Delhi.
That's right.
So it doesn't have in an immediate sense the taint of corruption. So they will be outdoing each other. The television studios and the courts, therefore, will be important arenas in the Delhi election,
right,
as much as we will see campaigning and the prachar phase, so to say, as it will unfold. So a lot of slugfest will go on. Each of them will prove to the electorate that I can handle corruption better. Okay. That will be the plank this time.
Rajdeep, just five seconds. Okay, I'm counting. First of all,
MCD is the most corrupt department ruled by BJP for 8 years. That will be an issue.
Okay.
Number two, Delhi Dialogue, proactive politics by Aam Aadmi Party.
Your time is up.
Dialogue and the...